Good morning. Still spinning podcast. I was a little late today. I didn't even know if I was going to do it today because I had a really good podcast to talk about, but then I split it up. So today is going to be kind of a part two of yesterday's Mighty Oak Tree Habits podcast. And then tomorrow I'm going to talk about momentum, adding some speed, putting the speed on. But yeah, I split it up because I have today's really hammered down and I just really wanted to have something for tomorrow as well. I'm figuring this out as I go. I'm trying to do this daily. I'm really liking it. And for those that don't really know, I'm actually reading this book called The Compound Effect by Darren Hardy. And I think yesterday I might have said Dan Hardy, so apologies to whoever. And today, I actually finished the book last night, but I've kind of been going back and forth through it. And I found really good parts about habits that I wanted to talk about that were really, really helpful. It's kind of just great information. I'm really liking this book, so I really like sharing the little pieces that really stood out to me. But there's a lot more information to the book, so I still recommend getting it. So yesterday we talked about the oak tree, blah, blah, blah. You can go back and listen to that one. But now it's talking about finding your why power. And it's basically when you're making these habits or finding your motivation in life, it's finding what's true to you and what your why is, instead of just trying to do these habits or good disciplined things strictly on will, because that's going to fail. And you probably failed in the past if you're trying to just force it. It's a lot harder too. It's much easier if you find your why, and it gets you through those tough times of the why. They always say follow your passion because of that. But you can just think of it in simple terms of, say I give you $20 to, I don't know, stay up all night, or like $5 to sacrifice your sleep for like a week or something. But if I give you $1 million, easier, stronger motivation. That's what they're saying. That's your why is a lot stronger of motivation. And to get to your why, they talk about, he says, to truly ignite your creative potential and inner drive, you have to look beyond the motivation of monetary and material goals. Even though my example was monetary, you get the point. And he also interviewed Tony Robbins, and Tony Robbins says, people that are not happy, that are really successful, they've been focusing on achievement, not fulfillment. And we always hear these cliches, but it gets more detailed onto why and different ways to find it, which I really like. So core motivation, the access points to your why powers through your core values, which define both who you are and what you stand for. And then another part I really liked was getting your core values defined and properly calibrated is one of the most important steps in redirecting your life toward your grandest vision. Toward your grandest vision. And then he also said, another part I liked was that psychologists tell us that nothing creates more stress than when our actions and behaviors aren't congruent with our values. I talk about that a lot. A lot of my things that I talk about is being yourself and avoiding self-sabotage by doing what other people want to do. And I always say try to do what you want to do and be true to yourself. But this is kind of what I'm saying in a much better way, is that it causes more stress when your actions and behaviors aren't congruent with your values. So when you're doing things and you know it's wrong, it's gonna cause more hardship in your life, and you're gonna feel worse in the end, even though you kind of did what you felt was right for other people and you're trying to make other people happy or whatever and you want to fit in the end it's gonna cause more stress. So I really liked that. What else we got here? Oh, and so if you've listened to my podcast before, I talked about quantum physics, that quantum manifesting thing where you're attracting things in your life. There was another part in this book, this one, that kind of changed it to be a little bit more scientifical, which actually changed my beliefs a little bit, because after that quantum book I read, The Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself, and also the quantum physics type thing, it felt like the law of attraction was very much pure energy, but this kind of brings it back to just your brain focusing on different things, which makes it more scientific. But if I think about why it's scientific, it's still sort of spiritual and whatever. But what he says is, when you define your goals, you give your brain something new to look and focus on. And we know that your brain is very subconscious, and we have all these different data coming in throughout the day so much that your brain can only focus on such a small fraction of it, like 1% or 5%, that it really can't focus on everything. So you know the example of, like, you see a new car and you're like, oh, what is that car? And you look it up. And then the next day you see it, or even later that day, you see it everywhere on the road. That's because now it's like within that 1% of what you're focusing on. So you see it everywhere. So the law of attraction is not just pulling new experiences. It's just that now you're seeing that in your 1%. So those experiences were always there, but now since you're focused on it, or now it's part of your goals or whatever, your brain has something new to focus on. So that's kind of a new way to look at that law of attraction, that manifesting type thing that I really like. I think they're both intertwined, but it's just something new that I was thinking about. And I really like it too, because it seems more realistic, even though I don't know what the hell's real anyway. All right, so far we got the your why power, find your core values, define those core values, what are true to you, so you can have the best, deepest motivation. And then also it leads into the law of attraction. When you're now defined clearly with your goals and your core values, it'll open up new focus and bring that focus into that 1% of what your brain's seeing on the day-to-day. Okay, so now you've defined what you want to do, and now you want to talk about, you want to think about who you need to become to achieve those goals. So you have your goals and your core values defined. Now it's about listing out all the habits that you have and don't have to become that person. So say, meaning when I say you have the habits to become that person that achieves that goals, maybe they're habits that are working against you, so you have to eradicate those. So make a list. And another thing he says your life comes down to, this is not what I was going to read, but this is another little formula. It's like your life comes down to this formula. You, and then your choice, which is a decision, plus a behavior, which is the action. And then that repeated action becomes a habit. And then time, which is the compounding of it, of that repeated action, equals your goals. So everything you have has to start with the choice and the decision. And to get to that choice, you have to have the clearly defined goals. And it becomes a behavior, a habit, and compounding that habit equals your goals. And then this is what I really like about making that list about things that you don't want. I always say, don't judge yourself, be objective, but he puts it in a really great way. And he says, making this list isn't about wasting energy by getting judgmental and regretful. It's about taking a clear-headed look at what you want to improve. So I always say that is like, sometimes when you do this assessment of yourself, or you say like what you want to work on, you realize you've been lazy or something like that. Don't be hard on yourself. Just get started now and start working on it. And don't waste any energy being regretful or judgmental. And then he gives some strategies for eliminating bad behaviors or bad habits, and I'm just going to run through them quickly. Identify the triggers, so whatever causes you to do that bad habit, like understand it and kind of acknowledge it so you can kind of work on it. And I'm going to go really quick through these. Clean house, which is just get rid of it. He writes, get rid of whatever enables your bad habit. So if you have it in your house, you eat junk food, don't even have it in your house. Don't buy it. Don't make excuses. Literally clean it out. I like this one a lot. Swap it. So if you have a bad habit like junk food, try to swap it for something that's a little less. So at least you're making progress. So you're not giving it up. You're not getting rid of it, but you're just swapping it. That might be a lot easier on you. And then the last two is either ease into it or jump all in. So think of it as like a pool. If you want to do something or you want the junk food, you could either ease into it, like I just said, which is swap it. I mean, you can kind of combine these, but what I'm saying is ease in is like make progress towards having no junk food, or you can do cold turkey and get all of it out all at once. There's different ways for different people. See what works for you. Let's see. And then getting rid of bad habits. And now for installing the good ones. Set yourself up to succeed. Any new habit has to work inside your life and lifestyle. And I really like that one because I find myself trying to add things that I want to do, for example, this daily podcast, that might not work within the lifestyle I have right now because I have work every day and I wake up early enough to get it done, but sometimes I feel rushed and sometimes I don't feel like I made a quality episode. So I want to find a habit or maybe change my habits so that it works in my lifestyle. But when you're installing new ones, make sure it works within your life and lifestyle. And that goes back to those core values that you know what's true to you so you can build your lifestyle and your life around it. And then the next one is think in addition, not subtraction. So when you're doing the junk food, that's kind of like the swap it one, is that you're not taking out, don't think that you're removing junk food. Think that you're adding healthy food, because if you're focused on the adding of the healthy, it's positive, it's good, it's a little easier on your brain. Not going to get too much into it. Public display, simply just state your goals to your friends and family, maybe post it on a podcast like this, like me, and like what I do with my dunk vlog. And so that way people hold you accountable. That's like something, these are all things that are different for different people, but that's really good. Find yourself a success buddy, just a friend that you kind of are accountable with. So you'd like maybe have a weekly call or something. Competition is great. So you just have like a competition between friends, pretty self-explanatory. And last but not least, celebrate. When you've added this habit, you can have some reward for yourself for being able to do it. So maybe have like a cheat day, a week of good habits equals a cheat day, or at least just acknowledge that you're doing great. And last, even though I already said last, is be patient. Patterns of thoughts and actions repeated many times create what's called a neurosignature or a brain groove, or a series of interconnected neurons that carry the thought patterns of a particular habit. Attention feeds the habit. When we give our attention to a habit, we activate the brain groove, releasing the thoughts, desires, and actions related to the habit. So that goes for good and bad. The bad ones are already carved in there, so it's going to be hard to remove them, and the good ones get carved in there so they become easier. That's it for today. I hope that's helpful. I really, really enjoy, I'm enjoying this book, or and did enjoy this book. Tomorrow's About Momentum is going to be really good as well. But I just wanted to keep these podcasts kind of short. This one's 10 minutes already. Shoot. Anyway, got a dunk vlog coming out today as well. Going to be editing that. It's going to be a big one from the past almost 2 weeks of workouts and two dunk sessions. I did that because the workouts were a little slow and I was fighting a cold. Other than that, thanks everyone for listening. I really appreciate it. I'm getting great feedback on these daily podcasts. I'm gonna do daily for at least this week, which means tomorrow, and then just probably keep going as long as I can. I just want to make sure every single day has some value in it. So I really appreciate it. Please let me know what you're liking, what you don't. Any feedback really helps me because I want to install these new habits and I want to make sure that they're useful and productive. So appreciate it. Have a great day. Enjoy your life. And we're still spinning, so don't get dizzy and stay aware. Okay, love you.